Whoa. Spec ID, please.
Wait, I just got a PlayStation 4.
Yes, we kind of had a new renovation to the placement. We kind of have new things.
Fair enough. I'll make my own club with 1080p 60 frames and devs.
Yeah.
You can go through.
Yeah. Look out, small group. Here I come.
It's a vlog. I'd like to thank my local Grange again for giving me this Dark Souls 3 lanyard, which is quite nice. Let alone a few weeks ago when you guys given me the Dark Souls 3 and badge. Wait a tick. Give me a second. Hey! That's quite neat. I don't know why, it's just a thing I just did to it. But yeah, I think I'll wear that during the vlog. Anyways, hi, I'm Stephen, welcome to Steety Films. It's a vlog. Just before I quickly mention, sorry for the reddish mark on my nose. Anyways, so what videos I did this past 1 week? I did a few videos this past 1 week, one of which that even though that I was unsure of, even though I mentioned my last vlog, that I didn't know if I was allowed to do any gameplay of the Gears of War 4 beta that came out this past 1 week for early access users. And even though on top of that there was like code giveaways on most sites and stuff, and even on O2 Priority, which is quite good of them to give out a code, which is quite nice. But in a nutshell, I did some gameplay of it and I was allowed to do it. Even though I didn't rush it, I managed to do a video of it and I did some alright gameplay, even though I'm somewhat rubbish with Gears sometimes, but I managed to record some goodish gameplay, which is quite good. So yeah, I did that, as well as Star Fox Zero came out this past 1 week, and I saved up whatever monies, and I thought I'd get the first print edition, and that I was thinking about getting in my local store. But the figures, though, as I mentioned on the video, I rang them up since I rarely use my phone credit, and since I couldn't go in the morning due to a certain thing, I had to stay put in the house since I had the painter over and all that, and I had to stay put in the house. And I rang them up and they didn't have a copy, even though during the week I asked them if they had going to be any stocks, and they didn't even have the pre-order things, so they were not kind of selected. But then again though, I realised after when I uploaded my opening video, I read up on an article on the internet that I found on someone's Twitter that there was a truck that was stolen of certain games that were Nintendo related things, and the first print editions being one of them of Star Fox Zero. I'm like, so even though that my local store was not somewhat selected, it's a shame that really that most people didn't get their first print editions, even though that ended up getting a first-ish print edition of Star Fox Zero. But it was nice though to get Star Fox Zero overall, and shame that I can't do any gameplay due to certain reasons, you know what I mean. But I'm enjoying the game so far. And I can see why Mr. Miyamoto did the control schemes, and just for a quick mention, my quick thoughts, that even though with the new control schemes, even though not much people are into it, so to say, let alone most people have been saying about it, but I grasped on quite a bit easy. It took me about a few minutes to get into, as well as I had a really experienced dogfight, and, you know, it just a nice dogfight with Pygma, and it's just using them control schemes and using the gamepad like a virtual, I'm not saying it was somewhat virtual reality, because you know it's a, you looking at this sort of way and you look at both screens, and I had an intense dogfight with Pygma. Oh, it was just brilliant, and I can see why the tensions of why Mr. Miyamoto did them control schemes in that game, which is understandable, and I can see why, you know, and all that. But in a nutshell, I'm really enjoying Star Fox Zero, but let alone other things, with Nintendo related things I can share. But other than that though, yeah, I'm enjoying it so far. So yeah, those are the videos I did this past 1 week. So for this vlog, I thought I'd share a story on a particular story that I've been having for many years, and it's now finally over now with a certain thing, which I'll mention this story, let alone a certain something that I picked up in this past 1 week, that and I'll mention something on top of that I picked up this past 1 week. So yeah, back in my day, I don't want to do any old joke references, but you know what I mean. But yeah, and just a few years ago, when Fallout 3 was somewhat of a thing, and I didn't grasp into it that much, so to say, because I never properly got into it, because it was one of those first games that I properly get into before I properly got into, like, you know, Skyrim, Fallout New Vegas, and some other games that Bethesda made, are well known for now and whatnot, let alone Fallout 4 in general. But in general, I never properly got into it until I started buying these, like, so-called DLC discs for Fallout 3 that were released at the time. And I thought it was a neat idea, having a DLC onto a disc, and you could just install them onto an Xbox and all that, which is a neat idea. And it's just a cool aspect of doing that. And I actually got both of them when they both were released. But the problem is, on the last DLC that they did for Fallout 3, I purchased it digitally, so to say, because it's the only way to get the last DLC of that DLC for Fallout 3. But I had the DLC discs for quite a while, and when they first launched and all, and I thought I'd pick them up. And the thing is, though, my friend borrowed them, and he wouldn't want to borrow that, and Fallout 3. I think he borrowed Fallout 3, or I think he might have gotten Fallout 3, I can't remember, but I still had my copy of Fallout 3 still. But in general, he borrowed them DLC discs for many, many years. Yes, and I still mention about that every time when we mention about some things he borrowed, even though he still borrowed a few things and all that. But in general, I will never see them DLC discs again. I keep thinking he may have sold them, or at the time when he needed money, or maybe when he was working in CEX. It's my friend who works in CEX, by the way. And I don't know if he traded them in, he needed quick cash. I don't know. It's him in general. But not saying he's like that, but I mean, what I think he would do, if it was him, sort of thing, he'd get what I'm trying to say. But yeah, I doubt that I've never seen any DLC discs again. Let alone, you can get them cheap now and again, because I usually see them in CEX now and again. I didn't think he would bother buying them again. It's like, hey, Stephen, sorry, I didn't mean to borrow them for various years. I know you keep bragging about it and all that. But yeah, I've just never seen any DLC discs again. And all that. And then jumping to 2016 now, I picked up a certain thing, because when I realised a past few weeks ago, when I did a little bit of research, because there was somewhat one YouTube video on YouTube about somewhat backwards compatibility with them using somewhat the DLC discs. But not just the DLC discs alone, it's the Game of the Year edition of Fallout 3, we use this on backwards compatibility, which I'll mention about in a minute. But yeah, I picked up Fallout 3, the Game of the Year edition, which I picked up for a really good price in the pawn shop, and that particular pawn shop which I got Rise of the Tomb Raider for a good price at the time. But then again, get for that price now with Rise of the Tomb Raider. No, I'm going to regret that at some point. But anyways, and over topicking. But yeah, got this for a good price of £6, even though you can get it from most places in different prices. But the case is somewhat okay, even though there are some, like, a bit of rip there, as well as a bit of a bump there. But still, but it's a nice, and the discs are somewhat okay. The main thing that I was interested in, and that is the DLC disc, mainly, so I can get most of the DLCs back, even though that I would repurchase them on Xbox Live, but it's more easier just to have the DLC disc alone, and it does work on the Xbox One, because when I was watching that certain YouTube video, I did a little tinkering on my Xbox One when I first got this. At first, it somewhat didn't work until I realised, even though I did install my copy of Fallout 3 digitally, that got free of Fallout 4. So I had to uninstall that first and then insert the disc 2. And then it installed Fallout 3. And I think you do need a digital copy of Fallout 3 to be able to run the DLC discs, because it's running like the digital copy of Fallout 3, and you do need the DLC disc in the Xbox One to be able to, because the license is on the disc to be able to read out and all that, which is a bit of a confusion when it comes to. It's like, but wait a minute, isn't the DLC discs already installed and whatnot? But you still need a disc inserted due to licensing reasons, how the backwards compatibility system works. Even I'm still learning. But then again, all this aside, I could be wrong though with the whole backwards compatibility with that on Xbox One. But it somewhat works, and I tried it and it does work. Even my save file that I had for many years still worked. And it's just nice to go back and play it and add a certain character wearing a certain item that I wear now and again. But yeah, and it's just nice playing it again, and you know, and it runs really, really good. And it's just brilliant though when you know, just playing like this. And it somewhat works, but you still need a digital copy there. That's the main thing, which is sadly to say, because how can you run two discs on Xbox One, you know what I mean? But yeah, that's the thing that I got this past 1 week, and it's just nice though to own this again now and got all the DLC back instead of doing a different methods on getting the DLC back and the DLC discs in general. But yeah, and the other copy that I have of Fallout 3, I gave my copy straight away to my sister, because my sister has been playing Fallout 4, my copy that is, because her dad, so to say, played Fallout 4 on the PlayStation 4, because her dad got a PlayStation 4 lately, and she saw him play it, and it convinced her to play my copy of Fallout 4, and I just gave her Fallout 3 whenever she does play it now and again. But knowing my sister nowadays, in her teen years, she's socialising, let alone her boyfriend and whatnot, which I'm a bit jealous, so to say. Some ways, what I've been up to this past 1 week, and since Monday, I had to sort out a certain thing because of the circumstances that I've been having, as I mentioned on my last vlog, let alone I forgot to mention, as you may know, I recently got a PlayStation 4 because of certain reasons I had to buy certain things, let alone, as I quickly mentioned on my last vlog also, that I'm getting stuff in the house sorted, let alone buying stuff for the house, let alone most things, as most people would say, let alone. People don't get their facts straight, so to say, like to build up things, let alone YouTube drama as it is, let alone, you know, YouTube drama has been a bit of a thing, so to say, lately on the interwebs and all that. And on that following Monday, someone came over to chat about certain things that my mum was there. And my mum has been so great for me lately. And it was nice of her to help me sort this all out, because it's not something I can do this by myself and all that. And we've just been chatting most things. And I got a bit stressed, a little bit. Most things I would say, but I don't want to say. Well, and most things I don't want to, would say, but I can't. But, you know, it's just, and I got really stressed with all this. Because, you know, I had a bad morning, you know, because it was all during the morning, and knowing me, I'd usually do my Monday thing in general, but I managed to do it all during the morning. I can carry on my Monday thing, and then throughout the day, throughout the Monday, just doing my usual Monday thing. I've been bumping into, and not saying some people that I know, just that I've been chatting to people in town, and it was dead cool though, let alone during that day also, and that's the day when Granger Games came with this lanyard, which is really, really nice. And I'd like to thank you guys again. And then just chatted with some other people. And I randomly bump into some particular lady. Not saying I don't know her, it's just a random lady. Because I was casually walking to Cash Converters. And because of the way I am, I was back and so I can let people pass, let alone bikes in general. Let alone the routine I usually do when I walk to work. There's usually bikes that usually come past me, let alone school kids that walk to school and they usually walk past. But, you know, I try to avoid them. That's why I always keep looking back. But it's how I am. And this lady was saying, oh, sorry, did I startle you? Like, I didn't mean to startle you. And I was like, oh, no, it's all right. And she tried to talk to me, and I had my headphones on, and I took my, oh, so I can listen to what she was trying to say. And then she was saying, oh, do you have autism? Like, oh, yes, I do, and all that. And she was like, oh, don't worry, it's how you are, because my little one, and who is 10, has an autism and all that, and I was like, oh, and all that, and it nearly brought, like, nearly a tear to my eye after what I had in the following morning, Lily, my scenes in general. It just put me in a great mood, and then during the night, and, you know, when the Gears of War 4 beta came out, and I've been playing that, and I've been playing with my friends on Xbox Live, and despite the morning I had on that Monday, I had a great day for the rest of the day in general with most things, like socialising, which is good. Not saying I've been having social problems lately, as I do, but I mean, like, it was just nice to chat to people now and again, like, in the situation I had on that following morning. But it's all done now, all sorted now, but for now, that is, like most things in general. But in the general, but the rest of the week, though, I've been doing this and that. And I've been having the painter over, and still now and again, as I mentioned, that I'm having my room sorted, decorating and whatnot. And I've been having early mornings, because the only days that I can have a lay-in is in today and also on Tuesday morning, because I had to get up early for that Monday thing on the Monday morning. Then I had to get up Wednesday morning for work. And then I had to get up Thursday and Friday morning so I can get up for the painter to arrive and whatnot. So I've been having early mornings, let alone today in general, that I was going to have a lay-in, but I somehow randomly woke up at like 8:20, let alone my usual time at 10, I usually get up, and I just randomly woke up. It was just a bit odd, really. But yeah, just in general, I've just been having early mornings, which is all right. I usually have my routines, but it's just so somewhat set, you know, getting up early and whatnot. But yeah, in a nutshell, I've been fine and dandy, just most things in general, which I would say, but I'm not allowed to say, let alone trying to build up controversy or YouTube drama as it is. Anyways, so what videos I'll be doing next week? The Rocket League will be having an update, a free tile update, and I might do somewhat gameplay of that, even though I'm not so sure what to do video-wise next week. But there will be an update for that and next week, which I might do a video of. And the Lost Reaver, if I pronounce that right, that game that's been on beta for the past few days on the Wii U, and it's a free-to-play game. But I'm not so sure if I might do some gameplay due to Nintendo stuff. But it's made by Namco Bandai. But I'm not so sure if I'm allowed to do any gameplay. We'll have to see in the outcome. But I've got some videos to do next week, which is good. Let alone I've been planning to do certain videos for the next few weeks that I have been planning since during my stress times, and I just try to keep myself occupied and plan my stuff ahead as I usually do. But in general, I've got somewhat videos to do next week, but I've got some videos to do the week after, which is good, though, in general. So, as I'll show up rambling now. So, that's my vlog for you guys. Hope you really enjoyed and watched to the end of the understanding. I know you guys had a great rest of your weekend since I'm recording this on the Saturday, since I got Star Fox Zero yesterday. and let alone, I think, the rest of the day, I think I'll just chill out. Now I've got to go out with my mum and do some food shopping for myself and stock up my freezer again with frozen foods for the next 2 weeks and whatnot and all that hibbery-jibbery stuff. I should really not talk about my life as that much because it does build up controversy, as most people would do, just do nitpick and all that. Anyways, I should have thought that now, but it's how I am. I was going to do something, but I don't want to do it. But yeah, anyways, and so yeah, I'll shut now. Anyways, I better go now. Do not forget to follow up on my social networking sites. And yeah, anyways, I better go now. See you from CT Films.